What we did in AC till now? Phase solution and analytical is done. Okay. So we have did any numerical on it?
Yeah, we did numerical on it.
Okay. Fine. So write down this LCR circuits. See, at times, impedance find, what is impedance by the way? What it is? Impedance is the equivalent resistance sort of thing, okay? Just like equivalent resistance is in the case of direct current, when it you find the equivalent resistance in case of alternating current, we call it impedance, okay? Fine, so impedance, for series is what, for series LCR, impedance is denoted by Z and that is given as under root of XL minus XC whole square plus R square. Fine? Okay? So, you know what is XL and XC, right? XL is what? XL is omega L and XC
1 by
omega C. Okay, so in case of series LCR circuit, we have derived this. Okay, can you find out the impedance of the parallel circuit? For example, circuit is like this. There is a capacitor inductor and resistance RLC connected across an AC voltage V naught sine omega t. Okay, so basically I want to find out what is this current I here. You can use phasors to solve this. Just like we have used phasors in series circuit, this is for series. Can you use phasors to find the solution of the parallel circuit? It is not in our school syllabus, but something which you should know. Draw the phasor diagram. What will be common among all these three? Voltage. Because they're in parallel, so voltage will be common. In series, the current was common. Okay? So what you did in series connection? Sum of the voltages is equal to supply voltage. You draw the phasor like that. Here what you will do? Sum of the currents is equal to this current. Fine? And voltage across resistance and current across resistance, they will be in the same phase. Not do it. Draw the phasor diagram first. If you don't come with revision of what you have done earlier, it will become very difficult.
So he wants to find current rates.
So voltage across resistance and current across resistance, they will be in the same phase. So this is the voltage V naught and this is also current across the resistance. Is this correct? Both the phases will have same angle, current across resistance and voltage across resistance. Resistance doesn't change any phase. Okay? And I know that if this is IR, that is IL, and this is IC, then phasor I is sum of all the phasors IR, plus IL plus IC. Okay. Now, how will you draw the current through the inductor? Downwards or upwards? Will it be same phase, 90 degree? It will be 90 degree ahead or behind of this? Behind, because voltage of inductor is 90 degree ahead. So current automatically is behind. Okay. Voltage is same across all. So this V0 is same for inductor also. But current across inductor, whose amplitude is V0 by XL. Okay. Will be 90 degree behind the voltage. Fine. So this is IL. V0 by XL. Okay. Now how will you find IC?
It's 90 degrees ahead.
90 degrees ahead. So it will be like this. So this is V0 by XC. Right? This is 90 degree, right? Now, sum of all these three will be the current, total current, right? Can you quickly find out? Others? You just need to add these three vectors. You'll get a total current. If you add these two vectors, what you will get? You will get this vector, suppose, which is equal to what? This is equal to V0 by XC minus V0 by XL, right? And then I will add this vector with that. So this is the vector. We will obtain this one. Okay, what is the magnitude of this vector? This is 90 degree root over this length square plus that length square. Fine, what is IR value? V0 by R. Right? So this, the amplitude of the current will be root over V0 by XC minus V0 by XL whole square plus V0 by R whole square. Fine. So this is the value of I0. Any doubt on this? Hence, if I take V0 outside, this is I0. Now, can you tell me what is impedance?
XL,
is this the impedance, this one?
Yeah.
Yes.
No.
One by R.
Because whatever is the equivalent resistance, V0 by equivalent resistance should be equal to current. Fine. So 1 by impedance should be equal to 1 by XC minus 1 by XL whole square plus 1 by R square the under root. Fine. So using phasor, you can solve this particular circuit also. Okay. But what if, like, you know, the situation is inductor and resistance are parallel and then capacitor in series and then again capacitor and one more inductor, they are in parallel. The situation becomes very complicated then. Okay, so you can't use phasor all the time. So these are the simplistic scenarios. Okay, so for to tackle those scenarios, we'll be using something called complex numbers. Okay, so first time you will be probably seeing how you can use complex number to analyze a physical scenario. Write down usage of complex number in analysis of AC circuits. See, what is XC? 1 by omega C. XL is omega L. Okay? And resistance is just R. Fine? Now, I mean, see, complex number is used to analyze a circuit. Doesn't mean that if I take XC as imaginary, it is imaginary. Doesn't mean that. I'm just using it as a tool. Okay, so what I'll do, wherever I see omega, I just multiply it with I. Okay, so what I'll do that IC is 1 by I times omega C and XL is I times omega L. Okay, so XC is imaginary, XL is imaginary, but R is real. Okay,
so why is that?
See, this will help us to analyze the circuit. See, in Arvind plane, real and imaginary number, they are 90 degree to each other, right? So 90 degree to each other, they should be treated separately, because this will not affect that. That will not affect this. Okay. Now, if it is 1 by omega C, it automatically becomes minus I by omega C. So when you add these two, they will automatically subtract, and that's how they should be. Getting it? Okay, now if you just take a series circuit, one R, then C and one L, like this, if you connect, see, I can understand there will be slight trouble in, you know, assuming XC and XL to be imaginary numbers, but we are not getting into too much of detail onto it, like why and how it is done. What I'm telling you, if you use complex number, you know, whatever you understand here, if you use that, you'll be able to analyze it completely. Fine. So I'm not getting into why complex number is getting utilized here. Just like we understood how phasors can be used without getting into why phasors are used. Similarly, here also, we'll be using complex number without getting into why complex number. Fine. Now, if you use complex number like this, then you don't need to treat it in any special manner. You can add it exactly like the way you have added in DC scenarios. What was a DC scenario? If three resistances are in parallel, you just have to add them up. Fine. So equivalent resistance will be what? Equivalent resistance, which is impedance, will be sum of this, this and that. So it will be I times omega L minus I by omega C plus R. Okay, so if I take R here and take I common, it will be I times omega L minus omega C. So this is impedance. Fine. Now this is a number whose magnitude will be what? If I just take magnitude of Z, how much is this? What is the magnitude of complex number A plus IB? Under root A square plus B square. Right? So if you take mod of Z, it will be equal to R square plus XC minus XL whole square. Same thing you are getting or not? Okay? And the phase in Arvind plane will be what? Tan of phi will be equal to imaginary part divided by real part. You remember all this? So this is XC minus XL divided by R. Okay. Now can you use the complex number in case of the parallel circuit and see whether you are getting the same thing which you have derived just now? So are you guys getting the same thing?
Yes, sir.
Sure? You're not getting. So in case of
Greenwood sponsorship, what happened to you?
We sent it to you, sir.
Wait, I forward.
When is this? 29th, 30th, 31st October.
October? Okay, and what is this about?
Sir, we have a sports and cultural fest going on.
Okay.
And there's more than 25 schools coming, so we're looking for
Greenwood High.
Greenwood High.
3 days?
Yeah, 3 days.
Okay, and then you have packages?
Yeah, we sent you all the details.
Cheap.
If it is connected in parallel, through an AC supply, this is R, this is L, and that is C. Okay? Now, what should be the equivalent resistance now? If I consider the situation to be very similar to how it was in DC, what should be it? They're in parallel, right? In DC, how you deal with parallel resistances? 1 by Z is equal to 1 by XC plus 1 by XL plus 1 by R. Okay? What is XC? Now it is an imaginary number. Okay? XL is I omega L. And R is just R. Are you getting it what I am doing here? So this will become what? I times omega L minus I times omega C minus I by omega L plus 1 by R. Okay? This is 1 by Z. Fine? So mod of 1 by Z, magnitude of 1 by Z is under root of 1 by R square plus omega C minus 1 by omega L the whole square. Fine. What is omega C? 1 by XC. And 1 by omega L is what?
1 by
XL. Okay. So you get the same thing. Fine. And what is the phase difference between current and voltage will be? Tan inverse of this divided by that. are you able to appreciate it is very straightforward if you use complex number? So the phase difference between current and voltage will be such that tan of phi will be equal to imaginary part divided by real part. Imaginary part is what? Omega C minus 1 by omega L divided by real part, that is 1 by R. So like this you can analyze any circuit. For example,
so how do you get the tan phi value?
See, tan phi is equal to imaginary part divided by real part. There you go. Let's take one example here. Inductor, capacitor, then you have a resistance and another capacitor. Like this.
This is the question, sir?
Yeah. Find out the impedance of this circuit and the phase difference between current and voltage. This is an AC voltage. This capacitor and this capacitor, they are of, let's say, different values. C1. And let's see, this is C.
So you also use cordial sample in time?
Yeah, I expect you to, unless you have other ideas.
if the C1 is the value of the X or the M omega L?
So C2 would be with R.
There's this.
Yeah, it would be in terms of it.
This is what you get? This is how you have done or not?
I have done it directly with formulas. Yeah.
Yeah,
basically, yeah.
See, XC1 is what? XC1 is, you have to use complex number over here, okay? XC1 is 1 by I times omega C1, okay? XL is what? I times omega L divided by I times omega L plus 1 by I times omega C1. Getting it? This will become slightly bigger expression, but don't walk down by that. So this will be what? 1 by I times omega C2 into R divided by R plus 1 by I omega C2. Don't talk. Fine. So this you just simplify, omega omega get cancelled, I also got cancelled. So you'll get this expression, separate real part and imaginary part of this combined thing, and then take a square root of real part square plus imaginary part square. Okay.
So can you do this?
Yeah. So I got this.
Okay, you have taken first the mod of this.
Yeah.
And then taken mod of that. No, you can't do that.
So I took.
So I just found the impedance of each particular one and then added it.
What you
have
done? Tell me now.
I took this impedance of this, impedance of this.
And added them both.
And added them both together.
Yeah, that's all.
How you have taken impedance of this like this?
So you can take this particular, take out the value of the...
Same thing I have done. Same thing I have done. This is what? 1 by XL plus 1 by XC1. Inverse of that. It is same thing. Okay? It's like you have written 2 plus 2 as 1 plus 2 plus 2. And I have directly written 2 plus 2 as 4. You have done the same thing. Okay? This is 1 by of 1 by XC1 plus 1 by XL. This is also same thing. Fine? So like this, you can analyze any circuit, and the phase difference between voltage and current will be what? Tan inverse of imaginary part divided by real part. Okay? Now it should be very straightforward. Okay? But then you can't use this in any school exams. You're getting it? You can't use it. Complex number approach. But this you can use as a shortcut to solve some objective questions which comes in exams like JEE.
So how important are LCR circuit, AC chapter in mains?
It's very important. AC is a huge chapter, as good as moving charge and magnetism. And also, see, the thing is, in other chapters other than AC, questions have been coming year after year, and they have exhausted almost every variety. So if some very nice or innovative question come, There is more chance that it will be from AC chapter, because not many questions were asked from this chapter in earlier days. Now they are asked in increasingly more and more. This chapter in semiconductors. Fine, so let us proceed further. Write down LC oscillation.